My thanks to all of you, and now it's on to Chicago, and let's win there.
It was a moment of victory and hope. Then gunfire erupted in a crowded pantry. A shocking event that changed the course of history.
Get the gun! Get the gun!
On June 5th, 1968, in this hotel, a man on his way to the presidency was shot to death. Was Robert Kennedy a victim of a lone assassin, or perhaps a shadowy conspiracy?
Now we return to Los Angeles to recreate a national tragedy.
I saw Bob lying on the floor, just on his back with his arms out.
We use 21st century science to search for evidence that might solve a mystery.
There do seem to be an awful lot of bullet holes. And that would favor the two gunmen theory.
We track the bullet trajectories.
Those four shots had to come from behind.
But who fired the fatal shot?
When you don't have full disclosure in these political murders, you're going to have conspiracy theory.
And was the truth covered up?
They were destroying photographs on a regular basis, uncatalogued, unaccounted for.
The assassination of Robert F. Kennedy on Unsolved History. In February of 2004, historian Daniel Martinez took a journey into the past, visiting the site of the Ambassador Hotel in Los Angeles, California, now closed for many years. As he wandered around the perimeter fence, Daniel reflected on that June evening in 1968 when, at the age of 17, he became a witness to history.
This is where I was the night of the assassination of Robert Kennedy. This was the headquarters for the California primary. And all the supporters and well-wishers came here by the hundreds, and I was just one of them. And right over there was the ambulance that took him away.
The assassination of Robert Kennedy was the climax to a series of killings that had begun with his brother's murder in 1963. Less than 5 years later, Senator Kennedy was in Los Angeles awaiting the returns from the California presidential primary.
What I think is quite clear is that we can work together in the loss analysis.
After delivering his victory speech, Robert Kennedy was escorted by maitre d' Carl Uecker to meet with the press. Contrary to what most people believe, there is no film footage of the actual shooting. As Kennedy and his entourage made their way through a narrow pantry, a Palestinian immigrant named Sirhan Sirhan approached from the opposite direction. Suddenly, the sound of gunshots rang out. Sirhan fired two shots, and then Carl Uecker grabbed him, slamming his hand to a steam table. Sirhan kept firing, emptying the eight-shot revolver into the crowd. Senator Kennedy fell to the floor. Five other people behind Kennedy were wounded in the attack. Robert Kennedy died 26 hours later. Sirhan Sirhan was found guilty of the murder and given the death penalty. Robert Kennedy's assassination seemed to be a straightforward case of a crazed gunman acting alone.
Sirhan Sirhan is in prison because he killed, and he alone killed, Senator Kennedy.
But what if the official version of the assassination is wrong? Questions in the case began with the release of the autopsy performed by coroner Thomas Noguchi.
Noguchi said unequivocally that the gun had come from behind. At close contact, razor contact range, in a down to up position.
But witnesses said that Sirhan was at all times in front of Robert Kennedy. Was Sirhan standing in the wrong position to fire the fatal shot?
It seemed like a string of shots, five, six. It wasn't one or two.
My bullet count in the Robert Kennedy assassination, 12 bullets were fired.
Sirhan's revolver held only 8 shots. How does the LAPD explain the extra bullets found in the pantry? And what about the security guard with a gun standing just behind Kennedy?
I was blown away by the contradictions, as well as by his position to Senator Kennedy, as well as his political beliefs. He was a racist. He hated Senator Kennedy at the time. And did he have motive, means, and opportunity? Unfortunately, he did.
Was there a second gunman involved in the RFK assassination? In order to find answers to these questions, Unsolved History assembled a crack investigative team. Forensic investigator Robert Joling. Terrorism and weapons expert Michael Yardley. And investigative journalist Dan Moldea. By combining their respective disciplines, we can use 21st century science to shed new light on the Robert Kennedy assassination. Our inquiry begins at ground zero for the assassination, the Ambassador Hotel in Los Angeles. Photos taken during the Los Angeles Police Department investigation give us a first glimpse of the crime scene, the cramped pantry just off the embassy ballroom. Chalk markings indicate where Senator Kennedy stood and fell. Strings delineate bullet trajectories. The room is small. It's impossible to imagine so many people crowded into this space, eyewitnesses to an assassination. The dynamics and enthusiasm of this crowd spilling in from the ballroom was the result of a challenging political campaign. By June of 1968, Senator Kennedy had emerged as a strong contender for the Democratic presidential nomination.
Bobby Kennedy struck a chord with people that was just incredible. I'd never witnessed it in anything in politics that I'd seen before or that I've seen since.